In this video, I'll talk about the course logistics. I'll tell you about the different components of the class, video, quizzes, homework, and tests, and I'll also point out the different features of the Complexity Explorer website. If you've taken a class on the Complexity Explorer site before, you can probably skip this video, since this class is structured similarly to previous ones. But if this is your first class with us, I suggest you watch the rest of this video so you understand how the course works and are aware of all the features on the Complexity Explorer website. Let's go look at that site now. Here is the Complexity Explorer website. This is the page for this course, Dynamical Systems and Chaos. The description page has basic class information, a brief bio of me, and also a little bit about the two teaching assistants for the course, Paul and Mackenzie. They'll both be available to answer questions in the discussion forums and also via email. Below that is the syllabus. This course will consist of 8 units. I'll post 1 unit roughly every week. The videos will stay online though, so you can watch them anytime you want. Let's go back up to the top and click on Lectures. This is where the course material is. There's a navigation bar on the right. You can expand or collapse each unit. Later on, there'll be additional units here. And then each unit consists of several subunits. And in the subunits, there'll be videos and then quizzes. A little bit about the videos. The videos are streamed via YouTube. You can speed up the playback time in YouTube if you switch to the HTML5 option. There's a discussion of how to do this in the FAQ. If you don't want to watch the videos on YouTube, or you live someplace where YouTube isn't available, you can download the videos here and watch them on your own computer anytime. As I said before, the videos will remain online, and you can watch the videos as often as you like. For most subunits, there'll be several quizzes. These quizzes are not graded. We don't see the scores at all, and they're not part of your final evaluation. They're a chance for you to practice and try out some of the ideas that I discuss in the videos. At the end of each unit, there'll be a homework assignment. These homework problems are optional. You don't need to do them, but I suggest you give them a try, as I think you'll get more out of the course that way. There'll be 3 different levels of problem: beginning, intermediate, and advanced. It's entirely up to you which level problems you try. Do what you wish. You're strongly encouraged to work together on the homework and post questions in the forum and discuss problems with each other. At the end of each unit is a test. Your final grade is the average of all of your test scores. Students who complete the course with a test average of 70% or higher will receive a certificate of completion from the Santa Fe Institute. The tests are open notes and open books, in that you can consult other resources and go back and look at the lectures if you want. However, you should do the tests on your own. You should not get any help when you do them. Of course, we are relying on the honor system to enforce this. Let's again go back up to the top, and I'll click on Course Materials. There's no textbook for the course. I will, however, post some suggestions for additional reading, books, and papers under the Course Materials section of the site. There's not much here now, but I'll add more as the course goes along. Let's check out the discussion forum for the class. Here's the discussion forum for the course. There are a number of different categories. Here in the forum, Introduce Yourself. This would be a place for you to send an introductory message so other people in the class can learn more about you and your interests. In Announcements, I'll be posting, announcements about the course. Another way you could get announcements about the course is by following us on Twitter. There's a link to the course's Twitter page on the main description page for the course. If you're not already on Twitter, there's no need to get an account. I'll post the same information on the Twitter feed and on announcements. But if you are on Twitter, it might be a convenient way to stay up to date about the course. Here in Unit 1, Iterated Functions, the unit that we're in right now, this would be a good place to post questions about course homework and quizzes and any of the material from this unit. In general, if you have questions about any aspect of the course, you can check the FAQ, the list of frequently asked questions. You can check the form to see if anybody's asked a question similar to yours. And you can also post a question yourself here in the form. If you prefer, you can send us email by clicking on this email icon up by my name. This will go to the address chaos@complexityexplorer.org, and this is an account that's monitored by the entire course team, so one of us should be able to get back to you quickly. So that's a quick overview of the main features of the Complexity Explorer site. In the next subunit, we'll get started with the material of the course.